Hey everybody, I'm back. I am making some rice broccoli and I figured why not invite you with me. So this rice broccoli is something that I picked up in St. Louis and it is from Fresh Thyme. I do know that Green Giant sells one, but it's not organic, and I'm sure whatever city you're in, you have your own version of Fresh Thyme that will have their own version of this. But I love this because I feel like I can make a different texture, and I can just make what I'm going to eat every day, which is broccoli, I can just make it taste that much better. And so I'm going to make this two different ways. One way is I'm going to spread it on my sheet cake pan. If you watch any of my videos, you'll start to sense a little bit of a pattern that I can saute vegetables, but then I can also roast them. So I'm going to pull this back a little bit so you can see me a little bit better. And then I'm going to put a microphone in here so you guys can hear me a little bit better. The rice broccoli. Yeah. Well, all right. There's one for the bloopers reel. Doing these videos is fun. Okay. So I'm not a professional at doing videos. I can tell you that much, but I'm sure trying. Just like when I was first asked to do the radio show, and it was like, I just want to make sure you guys understand that I don't have any radio experience whatsoever, and I really have absolutely no business being put on the radio, but if that's what you really would like for me to do, I'll be happy to get on there and start talking. But I made it successful for 7 years somehow, some way. So anyways, in case you missed it in the beginning, I'm doing rice broccoli. I picked this up from Fresh Thyme in St. Louis. And I know that there is a Green Giant version of this as well, but it is not organic. So I'm going to throw two bags of this on the sheet cake pan, and I'm going to spread it out pretty evenly. So let me get something to kind of do that with. I get almost like a spatula here, and I literally spread this out as if I'm spreading a cake almost, because I want it to be, well, like the thinner the better, because I know I've talked about this in other videos, but the more something's on top of each other, the more steamed it's going to get and the less browned it's going to get. So I always make a regular habit of, you know, really kind of trying to make sure my food is not like hyper stacked on top of each other, so that I can get like really good like crispness to it and browning of it. John, you don't have to stay in there. I'm just doing a video on broccoli. You're very welcome to come in here. Okay. I knocked the whole thing down on the ground, and then half of the light fixtures broke in, but I'm still doing the video because the show must go on, right?
Yeah.
So I've kind of spread this out sort of like a cake. So I'm not sure how much of that you guys can see, mostly because the light is actually blinding me right now. But that's what it looks like, fully spread out. Now, again, kind of funky, the different things that I do, but I like to spray in a situation like this versus pour, because that's going to make a difference on how crispy this is able to get as well. And I go across here pretty liberally because a lot of this is going to cook off, because I'm going to set the convection oven on. I'm going to set the fan. I'm going to turn the fan on this. And what the fan will do is it will really brown the top of this really good, and it makes it kind of crisp. So it's a great addition. If you have a convection oven, definitely use it. And this is just the 365 brand spray olive oil. You always want to look at the ingredients on this stuff because it's really, really easy to get bad ingredients in these sprays. This just simply says olive oil, and that's it. Now, another thing to remember, which I talk about all the time in my videos, so it probably sounds like a broken record to those of you that watch them, is to make sure that you are using a temperature that makes sense for olive oil. So make sure that you're not going over 325 degrees and that you are staying at a low to medium heat if you're on the cooktop. So I'm throwing this in my 325 oven. And then as I throw it in there, I'm going to turn my convection fan on. So now that's really going to kind of help to brown the top of it. And then I'm going to grab my Our Place skillet, And for this, I'm gonna use the bottle and I'm gonna drizzle this all the way across. And I'm gonna take another bag. Now I've thawed these. I've talked about it in my very first video when we first got to Florida, but I use my frozen vegetables as an ice pack. And so for my coolers on the way down. And so I already had those thawed and they just sat in my refrigerator in here thawed all week long. And so now they're just super ready to be cooked. And even though I'm just using a skillet, I could absolutely positively cook two bags of this in here. And if I was sort of impatient and wanted to make a boatload of this, I would absolutely do that. But it browns up so much better. And since I only have four bags, I'm going to just, you know, put one bag per skillet. And this is going to be so tasty. It'll brown up and just be delicious. So again, I've spread that rice broccoli all over that. So where it's almost like a broccoli pancake, which I can assure you, my husband would not eat. That would be the one style pancake that my husband would not eat. So one thing that's kind of fun about these pans is they come with these wooden spatulas and it has this little notch here, and then it just holds the spatula for you, which is really great. And then you can kind of hold it off to the side like this too, just to kind of keep it out of your way. It's kind of a nice added bonus. And these are fantastic. They really, you know, kind of help to kind of get things moving around the way I'd like to do it. So again, I'm using the bottle, not the spray, drizzling it all over the bottom. A lot of that's gonna cook off. So you wanna have enough so that you are tasting fat. I'm gonna spread that in there. This is four bags of rice broccoli that's going to be cooked. Two of them on the cooktop, two of them in the oven. Now, if I wanted to, this particular oven allows me to do two sheet cake pans like this on each shelf. And it has three shelves. So I could do six sheet cake pans if I wanted to. Not bragging, I'm just saying, like, I'm on vacation and I could make some broccoli if I wanted to right now, but I'm gonna go kind of easy and I'm just gonna make four bags, mostly because that's all I have. So I'm gonna put that just below medium. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually put my lid on these. So the lid's gonna go on and the lid is going to stay on. Lid's gonna stay on for about 5 minutes. And what that'll do is that'll get the bottom of it kind of browned. It's so tasty. You need to really do it this way. It's worth it. So I'll kind of brown the bottom of it and just start opening up. I'll open up that lid. I'll start moving it around my pan. Start kind of getting the rest of it kind of browned up. Now what I'm going to do with what's in the oven is I'm going to set a timer for about 15 minutes from now. I'm going to pull it out. Move it all around on that pan, and then I'm going to spray it again and throw it in for another 15 minutes, and then it's done. These guys, again, after that 5 minutes, I'm going to move them around the pan for about 10 minutes. So these are about 15 minutes, you know, doing them on the top. And then down here, it's about 30 minutes. That's why it's like you might as well do multiple sheet cake pans if you can, while you have the opportunity, because if you're going to cook one, you might as well cook six. That's a way of doing it. Now you could do that with riced cauliflower. They also add Fresh Thyme have a rice cauliflower and broccoli mix. And then they have a rice cauliflower, broccoli, and carrot mix. So just another way, if you get sick and tired of eating a specific vegetable, if you say, I'm tired of broccoli, I don't want to eat any more broccoli, don't. But don't eat it steamed out of your microwave the same way every time. Roast it in whole form, roast it in riced form. Get broccoli slaw and saute it. There's lots of different ways you can make the same vegetable so that you don't get fed up and sick of that same vegetable. I hope these videos help you guys. God bless you.